Issues of dividend consideration number 3, module 254, and the course is financial management. Before this one, we have talked about a few of the considerations related to the dividend policy. इस discussion में हम flotation cost की बात करते हैं. इससे पहले कि हम ये देखें कि flotation cost क्या होती है, let's first see that why we are talking about flotation cost. We have seen in the irrelevance theory of dividend that companies can always get more financing if they pay dividend by issuing more shares. And this was the concept of dilution that we also discussed earlier. But here, there is something which is called flotation cost of shares. Yani jab koi company naye shares issue karti hai, तो उन शेयर्स को इशू करने के लिए कंपनी को एक कॉस्ट इनकर करनी होती है. ये शेयर्स के साथ भी है, ये बॉन्ड्स के साथ भी है, और किसी और सिक्योरिटी के साथ भी ये कॉस्ट एसोसिएटेड होती है. यानी नई सिक्योरिटीज़ को पब्लिक के अंदर इशू करने के ऊपर जो कॉस्ट कंपनी को बेयर करना है, दैट इज़ कॉल्ड द फ्लोटेशन कॉस्ट. फ्लोटेशन कॉस्ट एक्चुअली इंक्लूड्स several other costs which are combinedly termed as the flotation cost. For example, there is a cost of underwriting. The term underwriting means that whenever a company has to issue shares, they have to arrange an underwriter. Underwriter ek aisi firm hai ya ek aisi company hai jiska kaam ye hai ki jo shares ya jo securities public ko offer ki ja rahi hain wo fully subscribe ho. यानी कि वो सारी की सारी सिक्योरिटीज पब्लिक जो है वो खरीद ले, उसके लिए वो अप्लाई कर दे. एंड इफ अ पार्ट ऑफ दैट शेयर्स और सिक्योरिटीज आर नॉट सब्सक्राइब्ड बाय द जनरल पब्लिक, देन द अंडरराइटर्स आर रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर दैट एंड दे डू चार्ज अ सर्टेन अमाउंट फॉर दिस सर्विस ऑफ अंडरराइटिंग. यानी उन्हें अंडरराइटिंग फी पे करना होती है, विच इज़ अ पार्ट ऑफ द फ्लोटेशन कॉस्ट. Similarly, when a company issues more capital, there is a legal cost involved in that. They have to hire some lawyers or team of lawyers, and this legal team has to incur expenses, and hence the legal cost becomes a part of the flotation cost. When the new shares are to be listed at the stock market, this would also require more cost, and so listing cost also becomes the part of the flotation cost. Previously, when we had the system of physical shareholding, yani jahan par share certificates physically issue kiye jate the aur unhe apne paas rakha jata tha, wahan printing and stationery aur ye cost bhi maujood hoti thi. But at the moment, because we have got digital certificates and we have got digital databases, so that printing and all these costs has been eliminated. But nevertheless, there is a lot of cost that a company has to bear while issuing new shares or security, which is called flotation cost. Now, this is the formula. If we want to see that what is the dividend growth rate, this is the formula that we have seen. But here we have got one new thing that we have not discussed before. Of course, the D is dividend and P is the issue price of the share, but F is the flotation cost of the issue of the shares, and this is the ratio that we take here. Now, if this flotation cost in terms of percentage will be higher, certainly it will have an impact. And if this cost is lower, if it is zero, let's say, then certainly there will be an impact on the overall cost. And small g is the growth rate, and we have discussed earlier in detail that what is growth rate and how it is calculated. Now let's put in some values and see that how does this flotation cost actually affect. Now, what we are talking about is using this formula, we are trying to calculate the cost of the new equity. If a firm is getting into issuing new equity, and if there is flotation cost, what will be the cost of that new equity for the company? Will it be the same if there is no flotation cost, or it will be different? The formula says that it will be different. Now, if we put in the values, suppose the dividend is rupee 1 and the price is 10 and the flotation cost is 7%, the ratio of this flotation cost, and the growth rate is 10%, the first part of the calculations, we can see that this comes out to be 20.7%. Yani jo nayi equity company issue karegi, uski cost company ke liye 20.7% hogi. Now, we assume another thing, that it is possible for the company to float or to issue shares without having a flotation cost. Agar ye baat maan li jaye aur flotation cost ko zero kar diya jaye, in the second calculations, we can see that the cost of new equity comes out to be 20%. And the difference of the two, 7%, 0.7%, is actually because of the flotation cost. So, is discussion ko yu summarize karte hain, ki ye jo consideration hai, jisko flotation cost kaha jata hai, iske andar hum kuch cost ko consider karte hain. Wo cost kya hai? Wo cost underwriting ki cost hai, wo legal cost hai, wo listing cost hai, aur iske alawa, aur bhi wo expenses, wo cost jo har us company ko incur karni padegi, jo naye shares issue karegi ya naye security ke zariye financing hasil karne ki koshish karegi. Agar flotation cost exist karegi, to uski wajah se cost of new equity will change. And if this will change, then certainly the decision of dividend being irrelevant will not be correct.